Bonjour mesdames et messieurs, in this video I want to show you a sunset retouching, something that I actually delivered to my galleries, the Yellow Corner Gallery, how I shot it, how I retouch it. I did a very similar episode on a dust photo, check it out, the link must be somewhere in this video. And this came because I was reading one of your comments and Monsieur Marcel Venn, which I cannot pronounce his family name, says, for another video, can you retouch a Paris photo or a few as you retouch them in 2021 for a publisher? So I was like, okay, I'm gonna do two videos for Marcel because I love Marcel. I don't know Marcel, but I thought he was kind of cool for asking this. So I did a dust photo, Marcel, and now I'm doing a golden, I'm gonna do a sunset. So I read all your comments. If you can take a second and smash the like button and leave me a comment and tell me what you would like to learn. I try to make two videos per week. I'm on fire, I need ideas. And you're gonna love this. Okay, so I wanted to show you one photo shoot that I did and how I retouched it for the galleries that I work with. Once upon a time, we had a beautiful night in Paris and I wanted to take a beautiful photo for a gallery. So this is the view of the Pont des Arts in Paris and the sun you can see is right behind the Louvre. Amazing, but there's a problem. A lot of people take photos with the sun in their frame. I try to avoid that. I find because the eyes only goes to the sun, you cannot see nothing else than the sun. So I try different framing to get the sun a bit more on the right side. I was underexposing my photos a lot because I wanted to get this incredible sky. And I knew that my RAW files had power in them and I could open the shadows and get so much details. Especially I shot this with like a Fuji, I think it's the 50 million version. Anyway, so I was not so happy with that. I don't know, I didn't like the white boats there. I love the sky, but I thought it was the foreground was very empty. So I moved around and then I saw this view, which I kind of like, but I thought the clouds, like this is the east, the other side of the sunset, and it was not so nice. Although I did love that cloud in the water, I thought it was kind of cool, especially this was during COVID and we had, the water was actually, there was no boats passing by for sunset, meaning the water was pretty flat and pretty mirror, which is only happened when there was a curfew on COVID. So that was good for that. And then I realized that in my life, I had never taken a good sunset photo of the Musée d'Orsay. What is the Musée d'Orsay, you may ask? The Musée d'Orsay is an amazing museum. It's an old train station. It's where you see a lot of impressionist art. There's so much art there. I've been there a few times, I love it. And it's just a beautiful, beautiful old train station. Look at that. Look at this place, it's massive. And so I was like, okay, I gotta get closer. I didn't like this on the right side. So then I decided to go in the middle of the bridge and I got this view. And I was like, yeah, that's the photo. I have a foreground element, which is this bridge. And then I have that. I'm a little far away, so I'm gonna have to crop. But you know, this is like a, what is that? That's, yeah, that's a 102 million pixel photo. Look at that, look at the detail. I can see the time on this. And I shot this at what, 160 ISO, so pretty good. And it's a little dark, but okay, that was a shot that I was gonna sell to my galleries. So how did I retouch it? Well, I, first of all, on this one, I think I opened the shadows a lot. Look at that, look how much details. That's why I underexpose my photos, because I always expose, like the way I expose my photo is I look at the back of my camera. And the theory is this, I gotta see all the little texture in the sky. I don't want anything blown away. And I can see that with my own eyes. And then the rest has to be dark, but not so dark, because when you open the shadows, you can see that. And look at this, it's not even so noisy. It is a little bit noisy there, but not that much. And okay, so I'm not gonna open the shadows complete on this one. I'm gonna bring down the highlights a little bit on this one. Not fully, this Fuji camera is so powerful that I don't even need to go all the way to 100. I'm gonna do that for now. And then I'm gonna hold on the Option key and I'm gonna set my black point. That just means that I'm holding the Option key on a Mac or on Alt key on Windows and I'm having 100% of black points. That's what I want. And then I'm gonna do the reverse with the white. And so what you see here in red and yellow is 100% white, which is not what you want. So something like that, and I'm gonna add some contrast. Okay, now I kind of like it, but it's really lacking of colors. I remembered it was a great, great sunset. What happened to it? Then I'm gonna crop this because I love 16:9. That's what I do with my gallery. So I'm gonna 16:9 it. And also it's gonna get me a little closer to, I don't like that. You know what, so I'm gonna just kind of crop that out. and then I want to get the clouds there. Maybe just a little. Okay, you know what? I'm going to take a little bit of that because I don't want to. I'm going to erase that in Photoshop. Cropping is an art. I'm telling you, cropping is an art. And I think, okay, what is nicer? Is the sky nicer or is the water nicer? Both of them is nicer. So I'm just going to crop something like that. Yeah, I like that. It's a little bit centered, but you see, now we're getting closer. Okay, now the white balance is completely off. I want to warm things up a little bit more here. So I am going to warm things up. But see, the problem when I do that, look at the sky here. Sky is kind of blue, and now if I add some yellow, which I kind of like let's say I go to shade, for example, which is like a classic sunset view. I like it, but what happened to my blue sky? It's gone. So usually what I do is I go to daylight, and then I add a bit of magenta. And then I'm like, yeah, but I gotta make this pop a little more. So in this case, I'm going to go to daylight and add back some yellow, just a little bit. But that's not all. I'm gonna go here, and I'm gonna take a circle where the sunset is, and I'm gonna add back some yellow a little bit in a circle. Just there, a big circle with some yellow just to make it pop. And I'm gonna use a random mask luminance so that it's not so visible. I'm gonna usually put it there, see before, after. What it does, it makes it go a little bit behind the bridge. Here it's over the bridge. You can see how the bridge becomes yellow. I don't know if you can see it on video in there. Okay, so it just makes it pop. But where did my blue go? I want my sky to go from blue to orange and yellow. Well, if only there was a tool in Lightroom that could do that. Guys, before I tell you anything, you gotta check out my Confession for a Photographer course. $27. It's over three different courses. The first one is my fine art photography course, which I give you. So it's a project like this, but you get over 20, and I give you the actual raw file so you can follow along with me doing it. In this case, you're not getting the raw files. If you buy this, you're getting the raw files. But you're also going to get my portrait workflow course, which is really cool to take amazing, cool portraits with the flash techniques, very non-expensive flash, like $50, and you get this kind of result. And also, I'm going to give you also the Lightroom black and white course today and yesterday, where I show you how I studied Ansel Adams' way of doing black and white and how I apply it today in Lightroom. Yes, it's crazy. $27, you're going to get all that. It's the deal of the century. Get it under this video. All right, so we're back. We're back. And now I'm going to take a gradient, and I'm going to make a gradient here. And on that gradient, I'm just going to lower the sky a little bit. Look at that. Right away, don't do it too much, a little bit, but add some blue to bring back some love, because it goes from blue to yellow, which is what we want. Now the sky goes from blue to yellow, and then I'm going to add another one here because I want to close the photo. I want people to look inside. Okay, I'm kind of happy with the photo, but I would do a lot more. I'm going to add a bit more contrast, maybe open the shadows a bit more, just a tad more. Yes, sir. Okay, I'm not going to add any vibrance or saturation. I feel it's good enough. And this is how I remember Crazy Sunset was one of the best I got over the whole months of May when I was there. And then I'm actually going to do a little bit of minus clarity and maybe add a bit of texture just to make things pop. Sometimes, you know what I do? Sometimes I actually do minus clarity and minus texture, and then I take a brush, but don't tell that to anybody. And then I add a bit of texture and clarity, but only on the brush and only on foreground elements like the Musée d'Orsay, the bridge, and maybe some of these trees and this. That's it. Not on the rest of the photo. I don't think you'll be able to tell watching this video, but when you make a big print, you can tell the difference. Okay, so now it's time to tweak the colors a little bit, because I'm still not happy with how it looks. So I'm gonna go to the U, saturation and luminance, and I'm gonna go to the U section and take this tool here called the targeted tool. And I'm gonna click here on the sunset. If I go up, it becomes very greenish, ugly, and I go down very red. But somewhere in the middle, sometimes you can get something kind of cool. So something like that. Yeah, just make it a bit more reddish. And then I'm gonna go to the blue sky here. If I go up, it becomes sort of magenta. If I go down, it becomes some of teal. So yeah, I don't know, maybe a bit like that. Okay. So, and now I'm gonna go to the saturation tab, take the same tool here, and maybe just add a bit of saturation just on the yellow here and on the orange, just a little bit. So I click and I drag up, and make sure you see here plus 37 that you don't go over like 40. Let's look at the U. Yeah, this is minus 41, that's too much. So just lower that. Make sure you don't have any value over 40. It's just a good way of making sure it's not too much. Actually, looking at it, I think it's too much. I'm just gonna add a bit of saturation, but not so much. Yeah, I don't want it to be too saturated. Right? And I really don't like this thing here and this thing here. So let's jump over to Photoshop and clean up the photo really quick. And then we'll be ready to send it to the gallery for print. And I hope this one does well. So here I am in Photoshop. That's gonna be quick. I'm gonna put this on its own layer. I'm gonna zoom in because I've got the zoom by default, or you can press Z for zoom. And then I'm gonna take the famous spot hitting brush tool. I'm gonna make it bigger like any tool in Photoshop. You hold on a control and option key, you click left click, you can make it bigger or smaller. And I'm just gonna paint on these people and erase them. Very peacefully, but erase them. And this, I don't like this. I'm gonna erase that. This is not nice to me. I don't know, I just don't like that. I wanna clean up the image a little bit, you know. Okay, and it does something weird there, that's fine. We're gonna do this in two steps. First thing, I'm using this tool, which is a spot hitting brush tool. So I'm erasing that, this gentleman's and their reflection. Here, there's a reflection. And then to finish it off, I take the stem tool, S for stem tool, hold on the option key here, and I'm just gonna, boom, finish that off here. And then you can take the stem tool, you can go back, J to the spot, J, the two touches I use the most when I clean up an image, J is the spot hitting brush tool, and S is a stem tool. So J, and then I'm just gonna, you see there's a bit of pattern repeating, so I'm just gonna erase that and that so it's not repeating. And voila, maybe clean up a little bit that water, just really quick. And I like that photo, I really do like it. And then, so then at this point, what I do is I save it. And then, so what I truly do is usually at this point, I let it rest. I don't send it to the gallery right away because I like to see if it's not too saturated or not enough saturated or too contrasty. And my eyes has been adapting while I was retouching and recording this video. So I go do something else or the next day I pick up the photo and I look at it with fresh eyes. I'm like, oh my gosh, it's too saturated, or it's not. That's how I do it. Now, one thing I forgot to do, because every time before I send to my gallery, I always make sure the sharpening is really good. I don't over sharpen my photos, but actually what I do, okay, so the photo is back here, boom, everything got erased. And it's good to do it before you go to Photoshop. You can do it after. So I'm gonna zoom in at 100% to see my noise level. Look at the quality of this photo, it's crazy. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go into the noise. And on this one, I think I'm just gonna do like 10 of noise reduction. Usually when I'm at 100 ISO, I do 10 of noise reduction. Sorry, I do 90 of sharpening. Oh my gosh, 90 of sharpening and 10 of noise reduction. And I do my masking. You see how there is like so much, look at the grain here on the clouds. If you do the masking, you hold on the option key, basically anything that's gonna get, that's black, as you move this to the right, is not gonna get sharpened. I don't wanna sharpen the sky. And now I got a smooth skies and everything else is pretty smooth and pretty sharp. And voila. And this is going to make a nice print. All right, so check out my confessional for a final photographer, link under the video. It's gonna blow your mind. Let me tell you a couple of stories. I've had a lot of students do this course and like they were not happy with their photos. And after doing this course, like people started, they started winning challenges and people started telling them the photos look great. You know, imagine if you could, you know, master Lightroom and Photoshop really well, if you could get the best out of your RAW files, if when you post a photo, you get a lot more comments, if you become a huge star. Well, that's happening down below. Confession of a photographer, click the link. You will thank me for it, I hope. Anyways, it helps me also to do all these free videos for you guys. Sorry for all the advertisement. I'll see you in another episode. Mesdames et messieurs, au revoir.